Hello, so today I'm going to be doing a review on what's in my camera bag and how I carry all of my equipment with me out in the field. So I figured I'd break this into two different parts, and in this first video I'm going to cover what I bring with me to a wedding. And so I have here in front of me two different bags. Both of these bags are ThinkTank bags. ThinkTank's an amazing company. They're based here in the United States. They have a philosophy very similar to our own. They make great equipment. They're not known for being the least expensive gear out there, but they have just truly a fantastic build quality, and these have really withstood quite the beating from me, so I'm very impressed with them. Getting into the bags, here we have the Airport Security version 2, and then this is the Urban Disguise 60 version 2. This is my primary bag. This is what I use probably 90% of the time when I'm at a wedding. This is usually on my body or within about 5 feet of me. This carries all of my flash equipment, my secondary camera, my backup gear, and any kind of miscellaneous odds and ends, batteries, just extra stuff, as well as sometimes my laptop if I bring it with me. Rather than going over all of the features of both of these bags, I'm just going to go over the parts that I like the most about them and what it is that I use about them. So starting with the Urban Disguise here. On the front, there's this kind of quick access pocket, and it's like a bifold or a folding design here. And I keep all of my quick access items in here. So I've got, you know, chapstick, tissues, all of my spare batteries, my CF card wallet. I also keep usually my cell phone, keys, just kind of anything that I need to have quick access to, I keep in this front most pocket. A nice feature of this bag that I don't use all that often, but is really convenient whenever I have needed it, is that this front pocket can open. And in here, there is a extendable, it's kind of this expandable pocket that has an optional divider. So you can fit either two pro size bodies here. Really nice to have. So also clothing. Sometimes I've just filled this up with clothing for a weekend, you know, super convenient pocket. And then this main flap, when closing it, there's two different options. It has a buckle, you know, a safety buckle, which you can use. I don't really ever use the buckle. I primarily just use the Velcro. I found that to be plenty sufficient for what I needed. Now, getting into the main compartments, you'll see here in the back, there is your standard laptop compartment. And then the main compartment, you'll notice here that it's rather spacious. I have four lenses in here, and all of it's assembled, including my camera body. I have my primary camera body, which is a 5D Mark III, and then I also have my 24-70. Now, this is the version 1. This is the L-Series 2.8 lens. My absolute primary lens. If I could only pick one lens, this would definitely be it. It's just very versatile. I love the 2.8 aperture, the fixed aperture over the full focal length. Very solid lens there, build quality. I've had this system right here for over 2.5 years now, I think. The camera body, I think I've had around 2 years. I got it pretty close to when it was brand new. And the lens I've had for a long time, both of which still stand up. I mean, they've gone over the world with me. You know, fantastic build quality. So moving on, the next lens, my most frequently used lens, is going to actually be my 70-200 2.8. This is the IS-2, the version 2. I absolutely love this lens. I completely adore it. This, if I could, I would shoot with this just primarily, but it's a little bit too restricting as far as its nearest focus distance, as well as it's a little bit too cropped for a lot of what I would like to do. So great lens though. Absolutely love this lens. All right, next let's get into my wide angle lens. This is my 16-35. This is the version 2. And love this lens as well. This is my primary landscape lens, but even at weddings, this is what I'll use for the wide angle shots, for family portraits, as well as the venue shots. Or sometimes when we're just in really small confined spaces, a small room, this can get you what looks like a larger room than what you're really in. You just gotta be careful about not putting your subject in the edges of the frame. You will get that distortion, so you do wanna try and keep them in the center. But if you keep an eye out for that, it is an amazing tool, and I do love this lens. And then lastly, we have my 100mm macro. For weddings, you're doing a lot of details, rings, flowers, bouquets. This is also though just a really useful lens. So that covers all the gear that's inside my bag. As you can see here, the bag itself, the internal system is not removable. These are sewn into the bag. The dividers are, however, removable, so you can completely customize this. And very, very spacious bag. As you saw, I've got four lenses and a camera body, plus miscellaneous other items. and all with the hoods attached and in their extended positions, and it fits it all no problem. So I really do love this bag. This has been a great bag. The only thing that I've actually ever changed on it was the shoulder strap. I had a different shoulder strap bag that, or a different bag whose shoulder strap I found to be a little bit more comfortable. Primarily just that the padded section was larger on my other strap. So I took the strap from my other camera bag and put it on this one. And that's really the only change I've made. So that covers the Urban Disguise 60 version 2. So here I have the Airport Security version 2. And this is my roller bag. This is my kind of big bag for when I'm carrying all of the gear that I need to fit. And this is a fantastic bag. So quick features about the bag that I like. You'll see here that it actually has a shoulder strap system that's built into it. So you actually can use it as like a standard backpack. The straps aren't the most comfortable in that position, but at least you have that option. Sometimes you just need to put it on your back and go. You don't try and be carrying it with one hand. So that's a really nice option to have. All right, so as for the organization of the bag itself, normally right here I have my secondary camera body as well as a secondary 70-200 or a long lens. And then here I'll just have a spare short camera and lens combo, so like a 50 millimeter or something like that in this section here. And then all of this I just have for flash. So I usually have 4 flashes here. Very convenient. I have my battery packs here. I don't use the Canon brand packs. These are just some third party. And then the batteries, I use these PowerX or Mahas. These are some fantastic batteries. Never had any issues, but if you're doing external flash, I would strongly suggest getting a battery pack of some kind for your flash. This will have a drastic impact as far as reducing your cycle times and your flashes. Very, very helpful there. So moving on, in this section, I just have a bunch of different flash modifiers. These are the Gary Fong light spheres. They're collapsible, as you can see here, but they're very easily extended into their normal size. And then they also have a lid, so you can essentially bounce the flash and spread it in a kind of a wider area. Especially, you know, really handy when you don't have ceilings or walls to bounce your lights off of. So fantastic flash modifier here. And then also it very easily can hold gels, you know, colored gels to do color corrections for your flash. So really handy accessory here. Absolutely love these. So I have actually a couple of them for the different flashes that I'll have. And that covers the big bag. The last items that I have are our monopod. This is our MC34 monopod, which I use with our MH02LR monopod tilt head. Very fantastic system. I use this pretty frequently for my 70-200, especially during the ceremony or reception times. When I know I'm gonna be doing a lot of standing and holding the 70-200 and a full camera body system and a flash, it gets a little bit heavy. Just having a monopod there really improves the stability issues. Especially when you're shooting with a flash, actually, because flashes, the fastest sync speed that they have is around the 200th. Well, with mine, they are 200th of a second. And so that's usually a little bit slower than I like to use with a 70-200. I try and be around the 400th of a second range. But with a monopod, I'm a lot more comfortable shooting at that 200th of a second range, not having to worry about camera shake and blur because the monopod is holding all that weight for me and it's helping to stabilize the system. So really a critical part there for the stability with long lens during receptions or long periods of time. So another critical part of, you know, how do I carry the gear? I've used numerous shoulder strap systems and I'm not a very big fan of shoulder straps. I just find that when you bend over, you know, your camera is prone to kind of swinging out and around you, and I've had it bump into things. I'm just not a big fan. Plus it has all the weight on your shoulders. I was not a big fan of that. After several really long weddings, having my camera bag on one side, the shoulder strap on another, my neck was just killing. And so I was looking for a hip-based system. And so what I use right here, this is Spider holsters. And they actually use an Arca Swiss style adapter. They make an accessory adapter. It's not the standard adapter that comes with the belt system, so you do have to get it as an extra piece, or you can get it as a replacement piece, but it works with our L plates perfectly. I absolutely love this adapter. What it does here is that this will actually just slide onto the bottom, and then it's just kind of like a screw knob style clamp. And so it locks it in place, and you've got these two little pins. And what these pins will do is when the hip belt system is on me, so it's usually in this position, it's really simple to mount my camera, and then it just rests like that. It's a very secure system. You know, I can be moving around, and it doesn't flip around or slide. You know, it stays exactly where it is. You know, if I shake it here, you'll see it's moving on my hip. So when this is on me, you know, wearing it like a belt, it's really secure. Absolutely love it. And then to remove it, it won't come out unless you pull the camera up and then it comes out. But they do have a locking feature here. So with the locking feature engaged, you have to press the lever in order to get the camera to come up, or you can just go all the way up and it'll click in the open position. That's how I use it the most, just because I really do trust having the weight of the camera in there. It really does not come up unless you pick it up. But if you're gonna be hiking or jumping around, you could just quickly lock that in and now it doesn't come out at all. So really solid system. And again, works great with our L plates. So really like this system, Spider holster belt. And as you can see here, I mean, I've kind of abused mine. I've had it for a couple of years now. Really love it though. So if you're looking for an alternative to a shoulder strap system, I would very strongly recommend these guys. But that covers everything. I hope this video was informative. If you have any questions, do please let us know. You know, feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. If there was any other area that I didn't cover, let us know in the comment section below. Anyways, this is Erik at Really Right Stuff, thanking you for watching.